when they have met, but again, the last one was in 2017. A lot can change in 4 years.
One up.
And Barbara, we already see the difference in style between a chopper and attackers. The very first point, we have a relatively long rally. You're going to see a lot of long rallies now because we have a defensive player playing.
One, one.
And one thing I'd like to say about that label, that they're defensive, they also have a great offense. But they go back from the table and they chop, but they all have great offense. If you don't play that ball correctly, they come in and punish you. That's a beautiful backhand dig there by Sir.
Two, two. Two, three.
This is going to be a test of patience for both players. And again, is a lower ranked player by world ranking, but she has won all three encounters in the past with Du.
One of the most difficult parts of playing a defensive player, we call them a chopper, is when they're playing from the pip side of their racket, you don't always know how much spins on the ball. Sometimes when you loop into them, you know that it's going to be pretty heavy, but when you push and they push back, very difficult to deal with. Like right there, you're not sure exactly how much to that. You have to kind of play careful.
Four, three.
I've played defensive players a lot, and it took me some time to learn that when I push to them and they push back with the pips, I tend to be careful on that one because I'm not sure exactly how much spins on it. When I loop into them and they chop, I know that's pretty heavy. And there's the offense.
3-5.
Of Sa. Haven't seen much of it yet this game, but Du popped that ball up. That was an easy forehand put away for her.
See Du attacking from both wings, the backhand and the forehand.
4-5.
Great table tennis from both athletes out there.
Five, five.
And that was nicely done by Du. She didn't put a lot of pace on that forehand, but she placed it right into the body of Sa.
Nice block by Du from the forehand, changing the pace, changing the expectation.
And it's that change of pace right there you just talked about, Barbara, that won her the point.
5-7.
Sa has a really beautiful high toss backhand serve, and it paid off at that point.
She sure does, and that ball is loaded with spin. Very impressed with her serve thus far.
Five, eight.
I like that serve by Du. Deep into the body, the forehand middle, we call it, of Sa. Unfortunately, she wasn't able to deal with that receive.
Nine, five.
That's generally not a good idea to try to backhand loop when you just put a heavy topspin into the backhand pips of Sa. That ball's loaded. And you saw Du miss that almost to the bottom of the net. Wasn't even close.
A really nice attack by Du. This is going to be a marathon for both players. And it's very, very calculated, every shot.
Well, we know that Sa is used to marathons much more than Du, right? Because of her style of play. She lives for the marathon. See, that's the shot I'm talking about, Barbara. Right there, Sa chopped that ball with her hips against a push from Du, and you don't know how much spins on it. Well, Du didn't either. She blew that off the table. You gotta play those balls careful. That one there is difficult to deal with. That's the one Du has to be careful with.
Right, Du is being very careful. Choosing the right shot.
10.
A really nice backhand.
8.
Du really winning points with a backhand kill. Usually when you play a defensive player, you use your forehand almost for the entire table.
That used to be the case, but in this day and age, more and more athletes are utilizing their backhand against choppers. I'm one of those guys that always did it. My forehand wasn't good enough to do a Janove Waldner and just run around on everything. So I tried to junk things up with my backhand.
Lots of patience here. Du, nice shots with her backhand. Oh, and Sa making a mistake.
Well, here's what's happened this game. No matter what happens this next point, Du has figured out how she needs to play Sa. And what we've seen the last couple points is the winning strategy for her throughout the match. She's more patient now. She's not trying to finish Sa so early.
And you're right, it's the right strategy, but she just didn't execute.
Through when she needed it, credit her. Here's the patience of Du we talked about. This is how she's going to play the rest of this match.
Oh, nice chop by Sa. Going to be just like this. Very, very patient, and she wins.
Love one.
And Du wins it.
Ladies and gentlemen, credit Du right now. She has finally learned that choppers actually don't like to play long points necessarily either.
Especially ones where there are no attacks. Nice backhand by Du and a finishing forehand.
Choppers love it when you come out and just try to blow them away at the beginning of points. They live for that. They don't actually want you to grind it out with them like Du is right now, pushing it back like 10 times in a row, doing a bunch of dinks.
Well, nice block by Du right there. But Sa able to finish that point.
See, here's what Du has done. She's sending a message to Sa. She's saying, okay, I'm going to make you attack at me, too. I'm not going to do all the work.
Oh.
1-3.
And how unlucky for Sa. Right when she's about to step around, Du had popped that ball up. It catches the edge. What a break for Du. Look at that right there. The ball clips the edge. That point was over. Point for Sa.
Two, three.
Well, now we've got a great table tennis match continuing, but a totally different rhythm to it, Barbara. This is completely different than the first half of the first game. It's a totally different chess match going on out there now.
Du coming back with her own change of spin.
And how about that, Barbara? When you start pushing with a chopper who's a pusher, you would think, well, they're never going to miss these. Yes, they do. She's missed two of them. They don't like you doing that to them.
Look at you, very light, nothing too powerful until she needs it. It's like building the point, one shot at a time. And she does it.
Hi, too.
This is great table tennis. Look at the waist and hip rotation. Look how she changed the pace there.
Three, five.
Oh, on the edge for
Four, five.
Very, very close second game.
Well, you know what? Sud deserved that right there because the same thing happened against her previously, so they're really even right now in good fortune.
4-5. Five, five.
And you can see why Du has learned to be so careful when she opens. She's having trouble reading how much spin is on the ball when Su chops the ball with her backhand pips. That one right there.
Six,
popped it up
five.
That time, so that was a pretty easy shot for Du.
And Su might look like she's doing the same backhand chop or slice every time, but it's different. The ball is coming back with different spin every time.
5-7.
You know, I play against a former top Chinese national team chopper here in Houston. His name is Li Qiwei. Let's look at this last point again right here. Good placement there by Du. I asked him, because I have the same problem Du's having. That's why I'm so well aware of it. I said, what spin is on it when you cut it like that with your backhand? You know what he told me?
6-7.
He said, I don't know. He said he doesn't even know. He says he just cuts it and it's different spin and he can't even control it all the time. So sometimes, you know, they purposely try to put a little extra, but they're not even always sure exactly what's on it.
A beautiful serve
seven,
by
seven.
Su. Tying it up, 7-all. Nice high toss, lots of spin.
Eight, seven.
Great job there by Du, just kind of half playing that forehand. Gave Su nothing to work with. A smart, risk-free play that rewarded her.
Let 8-7. Seven, nine.
Again, Du able to win that point with risk-free play. Took no risk, just played it high and on the table, won the point, and that's why she's willing to go to this strategy. She's getting a lot of points just playing real safe, slow balls against Su.
Nice forehand
eight,
by
nine.
Su, a finishing shot. But one of the reasons that Du is feeling safe playing slower is because she has been able to block a lot of Su's forehand attacks. Not that last one. That last one was very, very powerful, but other ones.
And it was the serve that really won the point there for Su. There it is again.
Nine.
Comes out with a deep serve. This thing is loaded. What a backhand serve here. Watch this. Look at the spin on that. Look how it jumped into the body of Duke. But what a great decision to go with the deep serve there.
Duke playing very carefully. Again, another test of patience and mental game, 9-9. Oh, and Sa taking the risk.
9-10.
Do you think Duke is being too careful?
Absolutely, Barbara. That's way too careful. And Sa has recognized that, and now she's looking to come in for an attack. You know, I saw this against Duke yesterday when she beat Lily Jung. She was very safe and careful that last game. I thought too careful.
And Sa capitalizes on being the one to take the risk. What a reversal. Hit a lot of those in the first game as outright winners, and she did it again here.
And that's clearly the strategy she's sticking with right now, is patience, lots of pushing, and she looks for the right shot, and then she'll take a risk periodically.
Very nice angles there and pace change by Duke.
Well, that was really well done right there. Watch this finish right there. Perfect technique.
One, two.
Two, taking the initiative again. Although she is a defender, she has a lot of attacking potential, and she is using that here to win the point.
Well, she knows that Duke is going to start pushing a lot at the beginning of points, so she's looking more to attack.
3-2.
Not easy to get a chopper to push one of your serves in the bottom of the net.
3-3.
When Duke opens with her forehand, so far this match has not been able to really open with any kind of speed or power, has been limited to only being able to open slow and safe on that forehand side. Now the backhand's different.
All those serves by Sa are so good.
Excellent serve by Sa. You know she's put in a lot of hours in the practice hall to be able to get that kind of speed and spin on her serve.
Oh, Sa ran so far for that, but Duke fast and faster on that finishing forehand.
By far. Four, six.
And Barbara, I can tell you one of the best feelings in the world when you're out playing a match like this is when you're playing a chopper and you push with them and they miss a push. It gives you so much confidence. They're not supposed to miss those shots. That's all they do all day, every day. But you've seen her do it several times. There's that sub again.
Six.
Talked about Barbara. So spinny. Caught Du off guard. Four times already.
It's the majority of her points, of Suh's points. Those serves, Du needs an answer to those serves.
7-5.
I'm not sure that's a realistic long-term answer.
But another great feeling is when you're having a problem with a serve and you get bailed out like that. That ball looked like it should have dumped into the net and somehow crawled over the net cord.
Oh, and Suh using her forehand, modern defender style, great attacks.
Fantastic offense from Suh. Watch this beautiful rotation of the hips and waist right there.
Net dribbler of her own. And now it's tied again. Just the top of the net has so much rotation. It almost went back over.
Seven, eight.
That's really been the winning strategy of Du. Is staying patient, pushing, looking for the backhand loop opening first because you can play it harder without missing.
Oh, another serve that Du missed.
She changed to topspin that time. She's been serving underspin. Got Du used to getting the underspin serve back and then went to the topspin right there.
And how do we know it's topspin? Because of the contact and how the ball bounced after Du hit it. She's going for that attack.
8-9.
Important point. Suh looking very confident.
The question is, let's look at that point again. Pops that push up way too high. Notice the placement of Suh right to the middle of Du. Timeout has been called. How Du plays here. Is she going to be aggressive and take some risks, or is she just going to sit back and let Suh dictate?
Nine,
well, she
nine.
Didn't have to take a risk that time, Barbara, because Suh with an unforced error. Really no reason for Suh to miss that. So Suh cracking a little bit right now at the end of this game. Now I'm wondering that Du just got that point for free. Will that slow her down and make her go too safe again? Let's watch right here.
Big serve coming up. Off the net. And another one.
9-10.
There's so much spin on these balls. The nets just keep coming.
Well, nothing feels better than good fortune. We all want it as human beings. And that right there is some good fortune.
And Suh clearly surprised that it went over.
10.
Tied it up. Suh's serves are too good. Really good rally right here. Du playing careful. Oh, wow. And it paid off that time. And the crowd knows it.
Well, very interesting point, Barbara, and a great point. Du has decided to play safe to end this game. And what happened this point is she had incredible defense. Look at the footwork here of Suh. That's the footwork of a chopper right there. Look how she runs in, she runs out.
Oh, and she didn't make
goodness.
It.
12-10.
Suh with a big mistake. Look how long the points are. Look how hard Du has to work just to win a point.
One up.
Sa has come out the first point of this game looking to be an attacker.
Ball is spinning. It mustn't spin.
So they're claiming that when Sa tossed the ball, she was spinning the ball with her hand. So that was a warning. They're asking Sa to toss the ball without making it spin.
Wow, look at those serves from Sa. They win outright. And as a chopper, you said this is a marathon. It's going to take a long time. And it's helpful for Sa to win points quickly.
Love three. Ball up.
So right now the score shows Du up 4-0. She should be down 4-0, so there's a little bit of a technical error with the scoring. I'm sure they'll get that corrected soon.
4-1.
Du on the scoreboard. Sa here with the lead, 4-1. And again with her serve. She's too good. Winning points straight with her serve.
So as a reminder, right now Sa is leading this game 5-1. There's that backhand serve, a good look at it.
Two, five.
Now we have a scorecard that is reading correct. Great job, guys.
It's a nice attack.
6-2.
I have seen defenders play where they're afraid to attack, but Sa is not one of them. And she knows this is how she's going to win this match.
So Du is fortunate that this didn't happen to her at the end of last game. What happened was Sa just missed some easy shots. So Du was very fortunate to win that game because she didn't play the right way. This is not the right way to play where you just sit back and push everything every single time because Sa knows that. So Sa is like a lion that sees her prey right now. She's just looking for the attack every time because she realizes Du is not going to do anything but play soft.
Nice serve by Du right there, but it's a long road.
Doing
a good job moving Sa around the table. Another key part about playing a defender. Interesting play here. Du is still playing very, very careful. Do you think Sa sometimes just makes a couple mistakes?
Yeah, just some unforced errors there. This strategy is not going to work for Du. There's no way she's going to be able to finish the game playing this way. Right now, she's so far down, I think she's just sticking with it. Seeing if she can get some freebies.
Beautiful rally. Du becoming the defender for a while, the Suh showing her ability to chop from far away on that forehand. Returning that where Du put it right in the net. Nice chop by Sun, so spinny, Du just moves it into the net.
That chop right there was so odd. She hadn't done a chop like that the whole match.
Du playing very careful, very soft.
That's inevitable. You can just see that coming. Du has elected to just sit back and literally take no risks anymore. And good luck trying to defend that kind of forehand from Suh.
There we go. That's what we need to see more of from Du.
She's going to have to take some risks. You're not going to win this kind of match at the World Championships just sitting back and playing only safe, only soft.
Ten, seven.
Sometimes when you're down, the big guns come out and Du is playing more aggressive here.
Well, still a long way to go. I think what's happening now is she's realized I've got to do something, and she's trying it now. You know, she's more or less using it for the next game.
A little bit lucky on that net.
Yeah, when you're in this situation, you just have to make the decision when you're down. Am I going to play aggressive or am I going to play safe? She played more aggressive these last few points, trying to see if she could make a few of them. She did, still down 2 points. Still
eight,
a long road back just to get to deuce.
She's playing very aggressive here. Oh, and it's working.
9-10. Timeout.
Smart timeout from the Korean team.
Du with the serve, so a good chance here to take the initiative.
Oh, wow.
11-9.
What a great timeout from the Korean.
A great
Love
Chinese
all.
Chopper named Lee Ki-wei, and I really learned how to play him better. And what they don't like is when you push with them and give them nothing to work with, and you wait for the ball to pop up and then do that. See,
Voila.
That's how I play choppers. And that's how Du needs to play Suh. The problem is she stopped doing that. She just turned into a pusher and a blocker and a slow looper. She never really took any risk. So Du's waiting for a ball to pop up a little. That's what she wants. At that time,
one.
That net caused the ball to pop up, and Suh with an easy forehand put away. So it was the net cord that caused that. Watch the net cord. We didn't get to see the net cord that caused that ball. That's why you see Suh raising her hand saying, I was lucky.
Again, on Suh's serve, so good. Winning points outright, just like we saw in the previous game. I have to say, it's actually pretty hard to serve your backhand with a high toss. It's so spinny.
Don't see it very often in the table tennis.
Very soft opening by Du on the net.
2-2.
Let's see if Du can serve and take the offense. She's got to take the offense. There you go. That's a good shot. Don't just sit there and keep pushing. Nice job.
And sometimes when you play a defender, if you don't take the offense enough, you start to lose your touch on the offense.
Well, you're right, Barbara. That can happen too. But see, Du played that point the right way. Just missed it.
Nice counter by Suh.
3-3.
And you can see Suh telling herself to play it a little slower, calm down.
Du Stu's got to be careful not to play into the racket of Saw when she does decide to use power. She had a chance that first forehand she played hard to go right into the body of Saw. She didn't. She played it right into the forehand racket of Saw, but she was able to win the point. But that's not winning table tennis right there. You got to find the opponent's body when you're playing with power and they're close to the table.
That was a good example of playing into the body. Stu seems to be building confidence in this game.
That's an unfortunate mistake right there. Gotta make that shot. That is an easy shot.
And Stu did set it up correctly.
Ball, ball.
And there's the athleticism of Stu. Having to come up with a circus shot to make that back.
Ball five.
I saw that point, defending well, and then the backhand put away with the pips. We haven't seen that shot very often this match. Excellent backhand from Stu. That's been her go-to shot this whole match. Really the only reliable shot she's played well with power. Starting to take some more risks, starting to have a play-to-win mentality. She's gonna have to do that the rest of this match. Let's look at this last point. Forehand drive. Notice she went into the body of Saw, even though Saw was that far back, still going into her body was successful. There's the backhand that we just spoke about earlier. The reliable backhand power loop of Stu works again. The power backhand of Stu right there.
Six, eight.
This is the most aggressive we've seen Stu play since the beginning of the first game. She's found a good rhythm. Let's see if she can keep it up.
Seven, eight.
That's that same forehand awkward looking chop that gave Stu problems earlier.
Eight, eight.
That was just way too passive there from Stu. That was so passive. Those kind of shots, Barbara, you don't deserve to win. So that's the right shot. She has to take it, just unable to make it.
That's a nice backhand.
Nine.
Well, that's the most beautiful backhand we've seen from Stu this whole match. Generally, she goes cross court on that. Watch her take this down the line.
Look at that backswing.
Look at that angle. Good close-up look of that beautiful backhand to the wide forehand of Sa.
Oh, and Sa has her match point. She is changing that spin on the backhand push, on the backhand chops. Let's see if Sa can continue to play to win. And she takes it.
Game two, and match.
She moves forward into the quarterfinals.